Championship Wrestling is sponsored in part by Castrol Motor Oil. Castrol, engineered for today's smaller cars.
Hello again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross and Jim Cornette here on TBS. We've got two great hours for you here, ladies and gentlemen. Some great action, including Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert taking on Jimmy Jam Garvin of the Freebirds. We'll see Captain Mike Rotunda meet the Cuban Assassin. The Road Warriors are here live as well, and we're also going to have an update on the World's Heavyweight Championship situation. Now, Corny, let's talk about this a little bit, okay?
Okay, let's talk about it.
A lot of matches that I have seen with Ric Flair and Lex Luger have ended with outside interference due to Ole Anderson or one of the horsemen.
No, what happens is Ole Anderson or woman or one of the horsemen, every time they see Ric Flair about to be ripped off, every time they see the referee not noticing something, they come to ringside and call it to his attention, the rule infraction made by his opponent. No outside interference.
Okay, I had a feeling that you might have that opinion of that, but let's assume that they have outside interference. How can Luger and Flair settle their differences?
Well, if you want to talk about stopping outside interference, if you want to maybe keep some of Lex Luger's friends from running into the ring and trying to rip off the Nature Boy, the obvious way to do it is a cage match. Because in a cage match, nobody can get in the ring and nobody can get out of the ring. It's got to be settled by the two guys in there, and that would be Nature Boy Ric Flair, because a cage match is right up his alley, brother. As a matter of fact, he won the world title at Starrcade 83 from Harley Race inside a steel cage. He can do it.
We'll talk more about that in the hour. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, a very special workout from Sting's Training Center. I'll have that report a little bit later in the program. We'll have our first match right after this.
This weekend, we were supposed to take up a new sport.
Mountain climbing.
Yeah, boy, I was really looking forward to hanging off an 8,000-foot cliff by my fingernails. Then I found out I could get a free game of bowling and a chance to win up to $100,000 in the A&W Road to Riches sweepstakes. So this weekend, it's A&W root beer and cream soda, our favorites, and some real fun bowling.
Next weekend, skydiving!
Look for the A&W free bowling display.
I feel like I want to be feeling. Look at the smile on my lips. I've got that M&M's feeling right at my fingertips. So carefree, they fit any plans. Milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hands. You want to grab onto that M&M's feeling.
Got a cold? Gotta keep going? Gotta go with Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine. When you gotta keep going, you gotta go with Alka-Seltzer Plus.
It was a nice, quiet town. Then came Crybaby Walker.
You're a dead man, Walker!
He's not just antisocial.
Rock and roll!
He was born to be bad.
How does it feel to be a juvenile delinquent?
It feels good, man. I've never been so happy in my whole life.
Johnny Depp, Crybaby, a film by John Waters, rated PG-13, starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
Tonight on TBS, they sacrificed their all-American boyhood to become men of the 101st Airborne, proud, loyal.
I'm with you, Holly.
Destined for greatness.
They say the fight they put up was one for the book.
Called to serve their country in World War II, they faced impossible odds on the battleground. 8:05 Eastern on TBS tonight.
Just look at that home wrecker.
Mama just
everybody's talking about it. Everybody's reading it. It's Wrestling Wrap-Up, the newsletter of World Championship Wrestling. Now you too can keep up with the latest breaking action. To subscribe, just send a check or money order for $24.95 to Wrestling Wrap-Up, 1 CNN Center Box 10576, Atlanta, Georgia 30348-5716. Wrestling Wrap-Up. You never know just who might be reading it.
Welcome back, everyone, to World Championship Wrestling. Norman, last week we saw you with a big black box. Now, I know that there's something in that box. I heard it breathing. Who's in there?
I'm not telling you who's in there, but he's good, you know. It's the boogeyman. That's who's in there, the boogeyman.
Well, Jim Cornette thinks it's a box full of Twinkies or something.
Oh, that'd be nice for me, hey? I like Twinkies.
You got a good boogeyman in the box?
Yeah, he's good. Like you, Jim Ross, you're my friend, and all these good kids, if you're good, then the boogeyman's good to you. You know, one time I was scared of the boogeyman, and I got up, and he was sitting on the edge of my bed, and I got up, so I read him a story out of one of my comic books. Do you know what story I read him?
Oh, what did you read him?
I don't know what I read him. That's why I asked you what I read him.
Well, I have no idea. When are we going to see who's in the big black box?
Well, it could be pretty soon. I'm getting ready to open that big box pretty soon. you want to know, don't you?
I really want to know. A big surprise for everybody?
Yeah, and you're a good friend, Jim Ross, so I want you can know pretty soon, too.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we may find out today, perhaps. What's...
Hey. Ninja Norman, I got a sword for you, Jim Ross.
Oh, thanks a lot.
You want a mask, too?
No, I probably need one, but I'll pass. Ladies and gentlemen, Ninja Norman will be back a little bit later in the program. But right now, let's go down to the ring. In the ring from Havana, Cuba, the Cuban Assassin. And his opponent is from Syracuse, New York, Captain Mike Rotunda. Captain Mike Rotunda and the Cuban Assassin getting started here on World Championship Wrestling. What a day. And we'll have more on the World Heavyweight Championship situation a little bit later in the broadcast. I'm joined now, of course, where were you when I was interviewing Norman? I thought you might have a couple of cracks to make.
What? The only cracks around here are in Norman's skull. He's got this box he's carrying around. He's a simple-minded, feeble-minded idiot. I'll tell you what's in that box. All the cities Norman has wrestled in, that's where they're buried.
Well, I'll tell you, he said we might see who's in the box today. I think that might be interesting.
There's nobody in that box.
I heard something breathing in there. I really did.
Maybe it's his house cat. I don't know what it is. There's nobody in that box. It's a product of his simple-minded imagination. You know what a hallucination is?
Yeah.
That's what Norman's got. He's got hallucinations.
That's the same thing you have, thinking that your team's the United States Tag Team Champions when they're not.
No, no. There's difference between hallucinations and delusion. I mean, there's a difference here.
You're right.
We are the U.S. Tag Team Champions.
Well, you don't have the belts, and you're not recognized by the World Championship Wrestling as a champion, so I think that there's a fallacy in that statement.
Hey, don't be using obscene language with me. Let me tell you something. We had the belts until they were stolen by Flying Brian and Z-Man, those cowards, those thieves. We had the belts. And I'm going to show you later on today. I've got a little piece of film to show. Everybody else can show their film. I'm going to show you later on what happened. Everybody saw it last week.
I'm sure you'll never forget it.
It's a bunch of garbage, man.
Cuban Assassin from Havana with an arm drag takeover on Captain Mike.
Where did
Norman go? He was usually here at ringside. Where did he go?
I don't care where he went. I'm glad to be rid of him because now it gives me a chance to tell everybody where the NWA is going to be this week, all the big action. It's going to be great this week. We're coming up on Knoxville, Tennessee at the Civic Coliseum tonight. Also Portsmouth, Ohio, the high school. Tomorrow in Asheville, North Carolina at 3 o'clock. Tomorrow night in the new Charlotte Coliseum. Monday in Gainesville, Georgia. Tuesday, Gadsden, Alabama at the Coliseum. Wednesday, Johnson City, Tennessee up in Freedom Hall. Thursday, Charlottesville, Virginia at the University Hall. Friday, we're in Washington, D.C. at the D.C. Armory. And next Saturday, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, back there at the Civic Center. I want to say hello to Frankie the Thumper and Dennis the Menace. And Meridian, Mississippi next Saturday at the Meridian High School. Meridian, what a garden spot that is. Their favorite occupation there is to watch senior citizens wrinkle. And then Sunday, we're going to...